Hey everybody, good morning. I am Pradeep Thakumar. Welcome to today's session. So guys, this is the tutorial number 8 of Jenkins tutorial series. On today's session, we'll learn to set up a job in Jenkins to build code which is in remote Git repository using Maven, and after successful build, the artifact will get deployed in Tomcat server by using Ansible. So this is the scenario number 2. Where we are using Ansible as a deployment tool. But in last session, we had deployed our artifact using deploy to container plugin. Okay. On some complex scenario, so we generally use Ansible as a deployment tool rather deploy to container plugins. Okay. So let's get started. So guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technology, different DevOps tools, VMware administration, Linux administration, and many more latest technology. So guys, I have prepared a small note for job setup. Okay, so we'll follow this document and we'll go ahead. Okay, so we'll set up a Jenkins job in such a way that so it will pull the code from the remote Git repository. Then it will start building the code using Maven. Then after successful build, so it will deploy the artifact to the Tomcat server using Ansible playbook. Okay. So for our setup, in our lab setups for this session, we have used three machines. One for Jenkins server, which is node 5. And another is Ansible server, which is node 1. And node 2 is our Tomcat server. So there is three machines. So why we have used our three servers in this case? Because in one Jenkins servers, where that code build will happen, that time after that, the artifact will copy to the Ansible server, where we'll run an Ansible playbook. Then through the Ansible playbook, we'll copy that artifact to the Tomcat server. Okay, there is three different machines. Okay, so precisely there is four step process. Okay, first we need to set up a passwordless login between Ansible and Tomcat servers. Okay, so why it is needed? Because we need to copy our artifact from Ansible server to the Tomcat using Ansible playbook. So that time that passwordless login is needed. Okay, between Ansible server to Tomcat. The second step, install public server SSH plugin in Jenkins and need to do some configurations. So why it is public server SSH plugin is needed? Because we need to copy, after successful build, we need to copy that artifact to the Ansible server. Okay, so for that we are using public server SSH plugin that we'll install in the Jenkins and we'll do some configurations. Okay, after that we need to create a playbook, okay, which will copy our war file to the war file or artifact to the Tomcat server. So one playbook will run here on the Ansible server, so it will copy the Tomcat. So whole flow is, so you know, it build process will start using Maven. Once build success, the artifact or war file it will copy to Ansible server over public server SSH through SSH. Then once it is copy is done to the Ansible server, from the Ansible server one playbook will be executed, then it will copy to the artifact to the Tomcat server. Okay, so this is our flow. Okay, so this is our Jenkins server URL and Tomcat server URL, because our Jenkins server has been deployed on 11.7. you can see 11.7 and listen on port number 8080, and Tomcat URL is 11.4 because our Tomcat server is deployed on 11.4. okay, so this is our three machines. Node 5 our which is background color is blue. So this is our Jenkins server. Okay, so this is our Ansible server. Okay, and this is our, the background color is black. This is our Tomcat server. Okay, there is three servers. Okay, node 5, node 1 and node 2. Okay, so this is our dashboard for the Jenkins, and this is the web URL for the Tomcat server, and this is our GitHub. Okay, GitHub repository where I have placed my code. Okay, this is my sample Java project. This is a repository where I have placed my code. Okay, we'll clone the code. Okay, through the job. Okay, so what is our first step? We'll set up a passwordless login between Ansible server and Tomcat. So we'll set up a passwordless login from node 1 to node 2. Okay, so let me node 1. So what is my IP address of node 2? So if I'll give hostname hyphen I so 11.4. okay, so this is from node 1 to node 2, we need to set off passwordless. So let me check. So it should so if I will not set off passwordless login, it should it will ask me password. So if I'll give do SSH to the node 2, which is IP address is 11.4 Tomcat server IP address, so it will ask me the password. Okay, now it is asking password. Okay, so after successful giving the password, so able to log into the Tomcat server. So in order to resolve this issue, we need to use passwordless login. So how to set up password login? So from node 1, we need to generate a RSA key, SSH -keygen -t RSA. Enter. So now the key got generated. So one private key, another public key. Okay, id_rsa.pub. So we need to copy that public key to the Tomcat server, to the destination server, 11.4. So how we can copy? So using ssh -copy -id, then the we need to give the IP address of the destination server. Okay, here it is asking password. So now it is got copied to the destination. So we can see also get.ssh, then authorized_, so it will copy to authorized_keys file. Okay, so now you can see this is the public key of node 1. Okay, now we'll try to log in. Now this time it should not ask me password when I will do the SSH. Okay, so now it is not asking. So now the first step got executed. So set up passwordless login between Ansible to Tomcat, it is done. Now we'll go with the second step, which is we need to install public our SSH plugin, then we need to configure so that we can copy our, after successful build, it should copied our artifact to the Ansible server. So from Jenkins to Ansible, we need to we will copy our artifact through public our SSH. So let me log in this is our dashboard of Jenkins. So click on manage Jenkins. Okay, go to global tool configuration, not global tool, manage plugins. Okay, so here you can see there is four column: updates, available, installed and advanced, right? So whatever the plugins installed, so it will show in under installed. So what are the plugins which needs to be installed, which can be installed, so which is available or available. So I'll click on available. So we need to install one plugin called publish over SSH. So simply I will search publish. Okay, let me check whether this plugin is available or not. So you can see publish over SSH plugin is available. So what is the functionality of publish over SSH? So it will send build artifacts over SSH. So that means it will transfer your artifacts to the remote location over SSH. Okay, so I will click, then I will install without restart. Okay, now installation process will start. Okay, once installation done, we'll go with the installing. Once done, we'll go with the configuration. Okay, so now it is saying installation success. So now I will go to Jenkins dashboard again. I will click on manage Jenkins, then I will go to configure system. I need to click on configure system, then I will configure there. Okay, so that our artifact will copy to the destination, that means our destination server is Ansible server. So now we'll go down. So this is the home directory of Jenkins, varlib Jenkins. So if I'll come down, so I will get this option. So publish over SSH, that option. Once you will install, this option will be available. Okay, okay, you have to install first Jenkins, then you will get this option. So, okay, now I will add SSH server. Okay, here SSH server I will add. Click on add. So I have to give some server name, suppose Ansible server. Okay, what is the host name of my Ansible server? So host name I am giving, this is the IP address, so let me copy this. Okay, Okay, next, you know, we need to provide the username. So in my case, in order to log into the server, so I'm using root. So I'm providing the credential code root. In your case, you can use some different username also. So remote directory, so in which location it will copy our artifact. So I will give under slash root. Okay, the artifact should copy it. So this is my hostname where the artifact will copy it using username root. So where we need to, again, we need to provide the password so that it will get authenticated. Okay, if you will not provide the password, then it will not able to do the SSH. Okay, so if I'll go test configuration, so it will get failed. Okay, so in if you'll click on advanced section, so it will allow me to provide the password. Okay, so use password authentication. If I'll select here, then we need to provide the password here. So in my case, my root password is admin 123. Okay, so this is my password of my root account of Ansible server. So now if I'll do the test configuration, now this time it should success. So if you can see success, because I provided the correct password. If you will not provide the correct password of the root credential, okay, then text SSH will not happen success. Okay, then apply, then save. Okay, so now we completed our second step. We installed the publish our SSH plugin, then we configured our target server, that means Ansible server. Okay, from Jenkins server to Ansible server, it will copy our SSH. Okay, then now we need to write a playbook so that it will copy our var file to Tomcat server. That means after successful build our public SSH, it will, the artifact will copy to the Ansible server. Once that artifact or var file copy to Ansible server through playbook, so which will run on Ansible server, it will copy to Tomcat server. Okay, so in this case we need to write a playbook. Okay, so let me log into the, this is my Ansible server where my, I have kept my playbook. So if you'll go to cat, this is my playbook actually. So guys, here in my Ansible server, I have created one playbook to copy that var file to the to the Tomcat server. So copy underscore file dot yml file. So this is the playbook, okay, through which I can copy my artifact to the var file to the Tomcat server. Okay, so in which host it should be, that this is the destination host. Okay, so if you can see here, so Tomcat server, I have group S, so I have added one IP address, so which is the IP address of my Tomcat server. This is the 11.4 is my IP address of my Tomcat server. So I have added one server. So if you'll see my playbook, so I have added, so that artifact should be deployed in Tomcat server, which is 11.4. So using root account, every operation should happen through the root account, because we have set up the passwordless between the node 1 and node 2, right? So between the Ansible server and node to the Tomcat server. So here you can see copy artifact to the Tomcat server. This is the copy module I have used. So I have provided the source and destinations. So from the Jenkins server, so it will copy to this location slash root slash target, and this is the var file. Okay, and it will copy, this var file will copy to the Tomcat server of these locations, USR local Tomcat 7 web app. So if you will go to this location, so to this location or Tomcat server, okay, to this location, this var file will be copied. So works with, I can, with this var file will be copied to this location of Tomcat server. Okay, so that's why so it will once the successful build, the artifact will copy to the Ansible server to this location root target, and this will be our var file, and it will copy to this location of Tomcat server. Okay, so that so this playbook will help us to copy the artifact to the Tomcat server. Okay, so now that playbook done, so now after three things done, we can go with the setup job. Okay, so this is the dashboard. So there is currently there is no running. Okay, so before going the setup job, so just I want to show you some things. Okay, so this is my Apache Tomcat dashboard, and this is my that GitHub URL. Okay, so GitHub repository. Okay, so from where I have placed my code. Okay, so I will click go with the create new jobs. Okay, so I'll go with my test job, then I will click on freestyle project, then click on OK. So I will provide some description. So this is my test job. Okay, so I will not go with this option. So source code management, because from where our source code is available, so I will provide the repository URL. So I have kept my Java code here. So this is a sample Java code. So I will copy this URL so that so it will copy the clone the code from this repository. So this is the URL. So if you have any credential, suppose if you have set any credential to your repository, so you have to provide the credential here also. So it will try to pull the clone the code from the master branch itself. So build triggers. Okay, in this case I am not going with any scheduling. Okay, so I'll do my job manually. Okay, then so there is two options, build and push builds. Okay, these are the option we are going to use. Okay, so now I am going to add the build step. Okay, so in my case I am using Maven to build the code. So I will select invoke top level Maven targets. Okay, then I'll go with the version, then I will go with the this Maven command, clean package install. So this is the, it will exactly what it will run, MVN clean package install. Okay, so it will clean, so whatever the old artifact is available, so first it will clean, then it will try to compile, then package, then it will install. Okay, these are the steps. Okay, these are the Maven commands only, nothing but. So this is our goal. Okay, so now if you can see, our build step got added. Okay, so after that we need to add post build action. Okay, so if you can see, if I'll go to my Jenkins server, var lib Jenkins, this is my home directory. If you go to jobs folder, now we have created one jobs, right? So my test job, so my test job got created on the job folder. Okay, so if I'll go to cd workspace, so you will not get anything here. Okay, as of now. Okay, when it will be now, it once the build success, in this locations one job folder will be created with the job name. Okay, under job the target folder will be created, under that whatever the after whatever the codes will be available here only. Okay, so now we'll go with the adding of post build action. So what if the post build actions, so in post build actions what will happen, so Jenkins server will copy it the artifact to the Ansible server using public server SSH, then from the Ansible server the WAR file will copy to the Tomcat server. So this is our post build action, right? So what I will do, so post, I will click on post build action, then so send build artifact over SSH. So this option will be available if we'll install that plugin, publish over SSH. That plugin, once you will install, you will get that option. Okay, or else you will not get. So first thing, send build artifacts over SSH. I will select it. So we had added that Ansible server only, right? So this is our target. So transfer from where, which file it should copy it. So we need to provide a source location. So I told you, right? So it will copy it from the under workspace. My test job folder will be created after successful build. From the target, it will copy whatever the WAR file, right? So in this case, what I will give, I will give the target, this is the location, slash, so whatever the WAR file is available, so it will copy. Okay, so this is my, so what I will do, instead of jar I will give WAR file. Okay, so target, from the target start dot WAR, from this location, from the Jenkins server, from Jenkins server, from this location, so it will copy the WAR file. Okay, now transfer source file, done. Okay, now we need to execute one command. Okay, once the file will copy it from Jenkins to the Ansible server, now the one playbook will run, which will copy from Ansible server to the Tomcat server, right? So in this case we can same command can be given here. Okay, but it is not the best practice, because might it will take time, and meanwhile that second command, if that file will not be available there, so then again this command will get failed. So the best practice, what you need to, we need to add another transfer set where I will give some commands called Ansible hyphen playbook, then the my playbook name. So what is my playbook name? This is my playbook name. So you need to provide the, so if you have kept under some different location apart from slash root, then you have to provide the full path. Okay, so this is the command through which we can run the Ansible playbook. So Ansible hyphen playbook, this is the command. Okay, so apply and save. So now we'll go with a review. Okay, then easily you can understand what are the things we did. So we created a job. So first build will start. So once build will start, at the time it will try to clone the code from this particular repository, Git repository. Then so it will start building with the mbn clean package install command. Then once build success, it will copy the artifact to the our Ansible server, whatever the war file available under targets. Okay, so it will copy to our Ansible server. Then once the artifact will be available in the Ansible server, then one playbook will run, Ansible hyphen playbook, this copy underscore file.yml file playbook will run. Then it will copy our artifact to the Tomcat server. Okay, so if you can see on Tomcat server, this war file is not available here. Okay, so once build success, that one war file will be available here itself. Okay, so now let me run the job. Okay, so if I'll click on build now, that build will be triggered. So build now. So if I'll go to console output. Okay, so now build started. So it will try to clone the code from the remote repository. Okay, so because this is the URL path, right? So this is the repository URL. So it is trying to clone the code from the remote repository. So cloning process is going on. So now it cloned the code. After that, it is trying to package the code using mbn clean package install that we had defined in the build, right? So now it is trying to, what are the dependencies needed, trying to during compilation or during test phase, what are the dependencies needed. Then now it convert it created one directory called under workspace called my test job. Then under target, that after compilation, the Java code will be converted to dot class file, right? Dot Java to dot class, right? So now all the files copied to there. Okay, now what it is doing, so now it is saying build success, because if you can see under target, so this war file got generated. Okay, so after generating, so it will copy this war file to the Ansible server using publish over SSH. Okay, so once copied done, so now that Ansible playbook, this playbook is getting run, so that war file will copy to the Tomcat server. Okay, there is three process. So build success, so after build success, that war file will created. So that war file will be created after it will copy it from your Jenkins host to the Ansible server. One in Ansible server, one playbook is running, will run, so it will copy that war file to the Tomcat server. Okay, so this is our flow. So you will get this type of scenario in your environment. Okay, there will be multiple scenario. So in the upcoming sessions, I will teach you some different scenario. Okay, so that you will get a clear-cut idea. Okay, so now it is copying. Okay, so transfer file is one. Now if you can see here, if you'll go to here, now that war file will be available. Now you can see earlier it was war file is not there, right? So using playbook, so it copied from Ansible server to here. Okay, this war file. Okay, now if I'll in Tomcat server, if I'll open this war file, so if I'll go to here, then if I'll go to this, so it should me the, it should show me the output. Okay, so now this is the output of my code. Okay, so in this way you can set up job. Okay, so please stay tuned for more videos. Thank you very much. Have a great day.